Hi, everybody. Greg Wilkins, back here with you with another edition of The Daily Pause, a devotional of positivity and encouragement for Wednesday, June 14th, 2023. I pray that you not only have a very blessed day today, but that today's devotional will also serve as an encouragement, a motivation, and an inspiration for you, and put a smile on your face as well. If you enjoyed today's devotional, please hit that like button wherever you're watching, and feel free to follow more episodes of The Daily Pause by following my Facebook page, The Daily Pause, my YouTube channel, Greg Wilkins, or follow me on Twitter at GregWilkins78. There you can like, follow, and subscribe to the Daily Pause, and you can leave your comments and as there as well, as including birthday and anniversary shout-outs for all your friends and loved ones. I do that at the end, as well as send in your requests for an inspirational song that you love to be featured as a part of the devotional, as well as sending in any encouraging words that you may have, whether you saw it somewhere or maybe you had something that helped encourage your life, either in note form or in video form. You can send those there, as well as reach out to me by email at glwilkins78@outlook.com or text me 864-860-1522. Now, I missed yesterday. I wasn't feeling great. I'm about 85% better than I was yesterday. Still got some drainage going on and didn't a little achiness, but I'm much better than I was yesterday. But let's keep going forward. I thank you for watching. I hope you have a very blessed Wednesday. And always remember, God loves you. God cares for you, and God will always be there for you. Let's get started with today's devotional entitled, The Pain in Potential. My sophomore year in high school, we just graduated a whole lot of seniors in our band. So it was really a young band. And one of the phrases we hated hearing as a marching band all throughout my years there was, "Well, you guys are a fine young band." It made us go, well, because a fine young man meant that we had the potential, but we still had a ways to go to get where we needed to get. But that potential was in us. And our band directors, Jim and Denise Hembry, saw that potential in all of us. And I'm only speaking for myself in this case, but they really saw it in me. I remember one class, Mr. Hembry was in charge of the brass, and we were all getting together, and we were three tuba players. I was one of them. There were two others, and they all kept going back for duct tape. And he says, "Why are y'all going back for duct tape?" I said, "Well, there are holes in our lead pipes. We can't play we can't play properly with the holes in our lead pipes." And back then we didn't have sousaphones. We had our concert tubas had lead pipes that we could convert to from a concert style tuba to a tuba you could play over your shoulders and march with. And Mr. Henry looked at me and said, "If you take care of your equipment better, we won't have to go through this all over again. We just ordered those lead pipes this summer." And I was mad. Why is he singling me out? Because he was looking right at me. It's like he was speaking to me. And after class, I walked over to him and said, "I don't get why you're getting on my case for something I didn't do. It wasn't my lead pipes that had holes in them. It was theirs." He said, "Well, you're section leader, aren't you?" He said, "Yes. You're responsible for what they do. If you see them putting them in those cases with the lead pipes still up instead of folding them down like they properly should, tell them to do it. That's your job as a section leader, to make sure that they take care of their equipment and take care of themselves in and off the field." I said, "Well, why? That's why I make all of you run. If someone's misbehaving in your section, I make you all run. So make you all accountable for yourselves, because that's what leaders do. They hold each other accountable and they be the light and the example of what accountability looks like." He said, and that place, he was telling me there's potential in me not to only be a greater player, but to be a greater leader. And by my senior year, I was chosen to be the band captain of the Chapman High School marching band. Going a little bit further in college, I remember my first lesson with Dr. Mark Britt. He sat down and I started to play. He stopped me and said, "You used to play trumpet, didn't you?" "Well, yeah, I started out on trumpet." He says, "I can tell your embouchure is that of a trumpet player. It sits down lower on your face as it should be a tuba player. A tuba player, your mouthpiece should be right directly under your nose. There's a little bit of space there." So he told me to adjust. And when I played, it was awful. It was awful. So I went back down to where it was. "No, go back up. It's going to sound bad, but I want you to keep on playing there. You'll get a better range and you'll get a better tone quality after a while. It's not going to sound good, but it's going to be better." And with each passing lesson, I got better. But with each passing lesson, he also showed me something else that was wrong. He said, do you know that you grunt before you play? I'm like, what are you talking about? And he pulled out his microphone. And he clipped it onto my tuba bell. And so, all right, just play this example right here. And I played it. And it sounds pretty good, didn't it? All right. And when I could play it on this computer, right before you start to play, I heard it. Because you're not keeping your throat open when you play. I was like, you got to stay relaxed. And everything I got better at, he found something else that I need to fix. Because he saw the potential in me being a section leader of not only the marching band, which I was, but as being in the wind ensemble. I hadn't even tried out for the wind ensemble yet, but I did end up making the wind ensemble because he saw the potential in me being a greater player than I walked in as. The same thing with Dr. Malvern, with the brass quintet. He told me, I think I told that story before, is that if you want to get better and stay in this quintet, you're going to have to practice outside this quintet. At that time, I didn't know I was in the top quintet. That's when I found out I was. When I started writing more and I got a chance to write a piece for the Paladin Regiment, Dr. Hicken sat me aside after all, he saw me floundering and scrambling. Said, "Just you got to learn to just prioritize what you do and stop freaking out." He taught me that because he saw the potential in me not only being, once again, a great leader and a great player, but also a great composer and a great arranger, being greater than what I started in as. And those lessons go on to this day. I even learned a lesson last week in my audio production. I'm using too many plugins. Sometimes you think it sounds good, but really it's just overworked and you're killing the sound. It's not being natural. That's what I heard. That's what I learned. So I'm learning how to do that better. I'm learning how to produce things better. I'm learning how to engineer things better from where I was, because the people who told me all those things, those various situations, saw the potential in me being better. Then the ball's in my court. The ball's in our court. People see potential in everything we do. The question is, will we sit on the potential or will we endure the process it takes to go from potential to better? In science, there are two forms of energy, potential energy and kinetic energy. The potential energy is the stored energy. It's the energy that that object or that thing is capable of doing. The kinetic energy is a display of the energy that that object has, and it's displayed at its maximum ability. So us going from our potential to our kinetic is a process. That's a change. Something's got to change to release the potential in us. And in that release comes hardship. In that release comes mistakes. In that release comes unfairness. In that release comes errors. And in that, we sometimes get fear because we just want to sit on what we know we can do. And that's it. We'll never get better if we don't challenge ourselves to get better. One more quick story. I was walking into my room and my roommate, Jay Calvis, my freshman year, I had a Super Nintendo at the time and he was playing Killer Instinct and he had it set on the hardest level. I said, "What level you got that set on?" It's like, "The hardest level." I was like, "Well, why? Why are you doing that? They're kicking your tails." Like, "Well, how am I going to learn to get better and to better do my combinations instead of having on the easiest part?" Anybody can beat the game at the easiest level, but you're only improving yourself to the easiest level. You can't get better until you challenge yourself on the next level. And that really stuck with me. We can't get better unless we get challenged. Something presses us to get better. A lump of coal can't become a diamond if it just sits there and just a lump of coal. It goes through intense pressure to change and manipulate its molecular structure to become a diamond. We are all diamonds in the rough, but we can't become diamonds without the pressure. And we can't become that. We can't become the diamonds unless we endure the pressure. The Lord told us he will never leave us nor forsake us. And through him, we can do all things. But if we know that, why are we so afraid to go through the potential? To go through that from the area of potential to kinetic? Because it's pain and there's fear and there's doubt. We don't want to embarrass ourselves. We don't want to make mistakes in front of others because some of them, "Well, he said he was good. He just messed up for the fourth time in a row. How are we going to get better if we don't make mistakes?" We got to learn from something somehow, some way. We can never do something just off the top, off the bat like that. And even if we do, it's going to be a time when we can do it better. We've got to endure the pain of potential because potential is just the introduction of the journey of greatness that are in each and every one of us. Each and every one of us have potential to do something great in this world. My potential may not be the same as your potential. You may have potential in a different area, but whatever that area is, don't sit on it. Don't just be satisfied with the potential and then live the rest of your life going, what if? What if I had put in more time? What if I had studied more? What if I had practiced more? What if I had kept working more? What if I kept working? The mistakes you make will help you realize, okay, I can't do that. You learn from it and you go forth from it. You learn and you grow. You learn and you grow. And God has a way of putting the right people in your life at exactly the right time to help you understand some of the things you're doing aren't right. Some of the things that you're doing are good, but could be improved by doing this, by doing that, by doing this. Then it's up to us to receive it or reject it. But one thing we can't do is sit on it. It's up to us to get up and move and operate in the purpose that God has for each of us. And sometimes that process is painful. Sometimes that process is the three U's. It's ugly, it's uncomfortable, and it's unfair. Sometimes that process brings about fear in our hearts and in our minds. But God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. And as long as we keep that sound mind filled with God's love and His grace and His peace, those things will keep, they'll keep us operating in those positive things. As long as we keep thinking positive, keep speaking positive, keep working positive, keep moving positive. We may have bad times, but they'll get better. A couple of weeks ago, Elon Musk launched a rocket into the air trying to do some things in there and exploded. And so I came to him and said, well, that was pretty bad that your rocket exploded again, but he had a smile on his face that, but look at the data we got. Look at what we got. We know some things that we didn't need to do. We learned some things that we should do better. But we also did some things that were good. Look at the data we got that we can improve on. He's going to take that painful process and go back to the drawing board and rebuild again. Sometimes we got to go back and rebuild again. Sometimes we got to go through some stuff over and over again. But as long as we trust that God's got our back and we trust that His will is right for us, we'll go through it. But we can't just sit on the potential. Just let it sit there because it's the easy thing to do. To get to the places we've got to get to, we got to do some things we've never done before. We got to work harder. We got to do things better. We got to put the time in to be what God called us to be. And keep trusting in Him. Now He'll keep sending us the direction. Keep sending us the instructions. He'll keep sending us the leadership to help us be who we can be. So not only to sit on that, but to help somebody else be who they can be. That's what we do by shining our light and being that example. And that's the example that Mr. Henry taught me as a 15-year-old in high school. Now, today's feature song is a song by Gloria Estefan, one of her great hits. The name of it is entitled, Get on Your Feet. So I know there's some times that we have that are just difficult and they're frustrating. But how can we get better if we just stay seated? We got to get on our feet, get up and take some action. You want to get better? Get up. Keep moving, keep pressing, keep enduring, keep on being better. The goal is just to be better today than you were yesterday. And then tomorrow's goal, if Lord allows us to see it, is to be better on tomorrow than we were today. Even if it's just 1/18th of 1/18th better, you're better. Even if you went through some things that make you feel like you're going back, you're better because you got through the day. Don't just sit on your potential. Be better. Get on your feet. Get up and take some action. Take some action on how you can be better. It won't start until you make it start. The biggest enemy we'll face in our lives sometimes is us. We block our own selves by our own doubts, by our own worries, because we allow the enemy to get in our head and start taking up space. And we start to get that chaotic mindset. We can never produce anything positive from that mindset. We got to keep our minds clear. Remember, we don't have that spirit of fear. God didn't give us that spirit of fear. He gave us one of power over the enemy, one of love and of a sound mind, that peace that surpasses all understanding. And once we have that peace, get up and work on what you're good at. Keep on doing it. Oprah Winfrey said a quote that do the one thing you know you can't do. The next day, get up and do it again. Every time you fail, get back up and do it again. Don't make the same mistake you made yesterday. You may make another one, but at least you know there's something else that you don't need to do. Keep on going. Keep on proving. Keep on impressing. Keep on pressing to be better. Get on your feet and make it happen. God's got your back. God's got you. God's given us all the tools to do it. Now it's up for us to just do, ain't nothing else to do it, but to do it. Let's get on our feet. Let's get to working on it. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for who you are, what you've placed in us. Lord, thank you for giving us the instruction and the leadership and the people around us to help us stay encouraged, even in the most difficult times of our learning and difficult times of our journey. Help us to understand that those failures that we face are not to make us think that we are at the end, at the end of our journey, but it's to help strengthen us and encourage us and challenge us to be better and to be the best that we can be and always trust you for what is in us. And to trust you that for those things that we don't understand, you'll provide a way for us. So Lord, we thank you for the promise and the potential you placed in all of us. Lord, help us to fulfill that promise to be who you've called us to be. And Lord, we'll glorify you and praise you every step of the way. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, this is the part of our devotional which we give our birthday and anniversary shout outs. And on today, we want to wish a happy birthday to Denise Anderson and happy birthday to Sandra Pearson. Sandra and Denise, happy birthday to you both. May God bless you with many more birthdays and enjoy your birthday on today. Also, I also want to give a very special 48th wedding anniversary shout out to Pastor Ralph and Elder Faith Davis. Ralph and Faith, happy anniversary. I almost said birthday. Happy anniversary to you both. May God bless you with many more anniversaries and may God continue to strengthen you every step of your journey. Now that's going to do it for today's edition of the Daily Pause. I pray that you got something out of this. I hope that you're encouraged to keep on pressing forward in the dreams and the goals that you have. Like I said before, God planted a seed on the inside of you, that nagging urge to do something, to write that book, to sing that song, to build that building, to learn this, to go back to school, to go back to whatever, to do something that you put on the back burner over and over and over, but it keeps popping back up. There's a reason for that. There's a reason for that. There's a potential in you to make that come to fruition. Don't give up on it. Yes, the process can be daunting. Yes, the process can be filled with mistakes sometimes, but don't give up. As long as you know you got the Lord in you, you can do all things and you will get through all things. And during those times of weariness, he will give you strength because his strength is made perfect in weakness. So continue to trust in him and he will bring you through. But it's up to us to get on our feet and get to working on it. Continue to love each other. Continue to be safe. And remember, every day there is always time to take a pause. Lord willing, I will see you again on tomorrow. Enjoy today's feature song, Get On Your Feet by Gloria Estefan, released originally known her 1989 album Cuts Both Ways. But this version comes from the greatest hits album released in 1992 by Epic, a division of Sony Music Entertainment. I hope you're blessed by this. Hope it's an encouragement to you. It's a pretty recognizable song, so I hope it's an encouragement to you and I hope it blesses your day. May God continue to cover you, increase you, and keep you in all that you do, say, and think. And I hope you are blessed. Thank you for watching. Take care. God bless. And I love you all. Enjoy today's feature song, Get On Your Feet by Gloria Estefan. God bless.